Hey, I'm Tucker Kuntz, a sales representative with Emergency Equipment Professionals. We're here today doing a final inspection with Clarksdale Fire Department from Clarksdale, Mississippi on their new Pierce Impel pumper. This pumper for them is going to be replacing a 1999 Pierce Saber. We'll walk around this truck and see some of the highlights. This pumper is built on the Impel chassis. It'll be powered by a Cummins ISL9. It's a 450 horsepower engine. It's paired with the Allison 3000 EVS transmission. For the front suspension on this truck, they went with the TAC4, the independent front suspension. This cab is the 6010 Impel cab. It has 10-inch raised roof for more room for the firefighters entering and exiting the cab, as well as when they're in the cab. With the red interior with black vinyl upholstery, appears to PS6 seats, hands-free SCBA. I went with the engine tunnel mounting bracket for mounting the tools and flashlights. Moving towards the pump house of the truck, they preferred to go with a top mount pump house. Up top, they have two cross lays. They're capable of holding 200 foot of 1¾-inch pre-connected hose. This truck has a Waterous 1500 GPM pump with a 1,000-gallon water tank. Look at the body on this truck. They went with the longer body. It's Pierce's the long body, 161-inch body, with roll-up doors. This compartment here is a full-height, full-depth compartment. They went with air bottle storage up top, where you can hold 8 air bottles in a 4x2 configuration. We use this lower part of the compartment as their engineer's compartment. Have a slide-out tool board. They plan to mount their adapters here, as well as other appliances. And in the forward part of this compartment, they're gonna put their pony sections, short sections of hose. On the right part of this compartment, put a divider in. They use this to hold different long tools, like their shovels and rakes and scoops, things like that. Have double air bottle compartments, forward and rearward of the wheels. Department here, there is a swing out tool board. They plan to mount all their hand tools here, their axes, halligans, the short pike poles, as well as they put pegboard on the back wall of this department for mounting more hand tools. This department here, they plan to use as their extrication department. Have a 500 pound capacity slide out tray. We're gonna put their cutters, spreaders, and rams on this one. Moving to the rear of the truck, you see up top they did hatch compartments. Their plan with the hatch compartments is to the things that they have on the truck that they seldomly use, but they still have to have, they plan to store up there, like extra cribbing, rope rescue equipment, water rescue equipment. They have pre-connects at the rear. They'll be on the left side, 150 foot of 1¾-inch, the right side another 150 foot of 1¾-inch connected to your 2.5-inch outlets. In the center section, they'll hold their LDH. This truck is capable of holding 1,000 foot of 5-inch and then 400 foot of 3-inch. This rear compartment have a booster reel. It's 150 foot of 1-inch booster reel, and they put a shelf up top. They plan to use that to hold their hydrant bag. The ladder compartment have a 24 foot two-section, a 14 foot roof ladder, as well as up top in the trough, a 10 foot folding attic ladder, and then two pike pole troughs. Clarksdale plans to use this department, compartment as their ventilation compartment. Another slide out tray to put their PPV fan in it, as well as a K12 and chainsaws on the shelf. Have triple air bottle compartments, forward and rearward of the wheels here. This compartment here, they have pegboard on the back wall for mounting miscellaneous hand tools. Another compartment here for additional storage. Front bumper on this truck is a 16-inch extended front bumper. They went with the steel painted bumper with the black and red chevron. They also put a Linex coating on the top flange of the bumper to help protect the paint. A Clarksdale Fire Department, they loaded this truck out with an abundance of scene and warning lights. The warning light package is going to be Wayland C-Series. And the light bar is a 72-inch Freedom light bar by Wayland. Scene lights are all 12-volt Pioneer Plus scene lights on the sides. And they went with a 72-inch high-vis visor light. Neat thing about this light, it has the marker lights integrated. Hey, thank you for watching as we walked around Clarksdale Fire Department's new Pierce Impel Pumper.